हेलो, वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट गेट 2015 ईसीई पेपर। दिस क्वेश्चन इज रिलेटेड टू एनालॉग सर्किट्स। लुक एट द सर्किट डायग्राम विथ आइडियल ऑप एम्प एंड वी नीड टू फाइंड 3 dB कट ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ दिस सर्किट्स एंड द सेम सर्किट कैन बी रीड्रन लाइक दिस। ओके, लुक एट बोथ द सर्किट्स। जस्ट सिंपली व्हाट आई हैव डन इज ग्राउंड इज गोइंग टू बी सेपरेटेड फॉर कैपेसिटर एज वेल एज रेसिस्टर। That's all. Okay. Now, if you observe, this operational amplifier is going to be having a negative feedback since output is fed back to inverting terminal and actual input signal is connecting towards non-inverting terminal. So, this is going to be acting as non-inverting op amp. This circuit is now acting as non-inverting op amp. Non-inverting op amp provides a gain of 1 plus RF by R1, where RF is nothing but feedback resistor, R1 is nothing but a simple resistor which connected at inverting terminal. And V0 can be represented as V0 is equal to 1 plus RF by R1. This is a gain provided by non-inverting op amp for the voltage present at non-inverting terminal. That is, V0 is 1 plus RF by R1 into V plus. V plus is voltage across non-inverting terminal, and this voltage and the voltage across this capacitor both are going to be same. This is also V plus, this is also V plus, because ideal operational amplifier no current is drawn into input terminals of ideal operational amplifier. Not only this one, for practical op amp also you can also take this assumption. This assumption is valid for both practical as well as ideal operational amplifiers. So, current flowing through inverting and non-inverting terminals is always zero. Since no current is flowing, no voltage drop takes place across this 10 kilo ohms. Whenever no voltage drop is taking place at that time, it is simply acting as a short circuit. Since no voltage drop means 0 volts, 0 volts is nothing but short circuit. So, this voltage at exactly non-inverting terminal input and voltage across capacitor is also same. So where V plus is nothing but output of simple low pass filter. If you are observing this one, this circuit is going to be acting as a simple low pass filter, okay, and which will be having a cutoff frequency, that is upper cutoff frequency. Every low pass filter, as the name implies, it passes all lower frequencies up to a cutoff frequency which is called as FH. FH is upper cutoff frequency. This is the maximum frequency which a low pass filter can pass. Okay. So, this FH is also called as 3 dB frequency. So, upper cutoff frequency, it is also called as 3 dB frequency for a low pass filter. And we know FH can be calculated for a simple low pass filter using 1 by 2 pi RC. So, directly we can tell the answer from this one. FH is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC and R value is 10 kilo ohms and C value is 0.1 microfarad. These are the two elements. So, if you substitute those values, 1 by 2 pi times of R value is nothing but 10 kilo and C value is 0.1 microfarad. So, this will be equal to 159.15 hedges. So, the right answer for this question, that is 3 dB cutoff frequency, is 159.15 hedges. Okay. So, this circuit configuration is also called as active filter, active low pass filter of first order. Generally, low pass filter, whenever it is passing, it is going to be reducing the gain or it may be giving the same signal. It never be amplified. So, the disadvantage can be overcome if you are using active filter. Active filter is nothing but you are giving the output of low pass filter or high pass filter, that is output of a filter to an active element which is going to be acting as amplifier. So, here operational amplifier along with RF and R1, it is acting as non-inverting op amp which provides a gain of 1 plus RF by R1. The value of 1 plus RF by R1 according to this circuit is 2. So, the output of low pass filter is amplified by 2 times and appears at the output of V0. That is the purpose of active filter. Okay. And answer for this one is 159.15 hedges. Thank you.